Welcome to the Fit Small Business QuickBooks Online training course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to import credit card transactions into QuickBooks Online. So follow along with me, log into your QuickBooks Online account now, or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. You can also click this link to access our full QuickBooks Online course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. One of the many benefits of QuickBooks Online is that you can save a lot of time by automatically downloading your credit card transactions into QuickBooks instead of manually inputting each transaction. While most big banks, like Bank of America, allow you to quickly and easily connect to QuickBooks, some of the smaller banks and credit unions do not have that capability. If you are interested in opening a credit card, we recommend you check out Bank of America. Click this link for more information. If you don't have a business credit card and you are using a personal credit card, then you should set up a separate business credit card as soon as possible and get it connected to QuickBooks. It is always best practice from an accounting and tax standpoint to keep business activities completely separate from personal. Having a separate business credit card can also help you build business credit. Click this link for more information. For the purposes of this video, we will use a fictitious company called Paul's Plumbing. As you view this video, think about how the information might differ for your business. In order to connect your credit card account to QuickBooks, you will need your online user ID and password to log into your account. Once you have logged into QuickBooks Online, from the homepage, click on the Transactions tab and then Banking on the left menu bar. In the upper right-hand corner, click on the Add Account button. And then you can either type your credit card name in the search box here or select from the list of banks below. So Paul banks with Bank of America, so we will select that. If you are unable to locate your credit card company or you need to download more than 90 days of credit card transactions, then you need to upload credit card transactions using CSV format, which is covered later in this lesson. Let's go ahead and get logged into the bank account here. Depending on your internet connection and the number of accounts that you have, it may take a few minutes for QuickBooks to connect to your bank once we log in. Once QuickBooks has made the connection, you will see a screen similar to this one. What we want to do is go ahead and place a check mark in the first column for each account that you would like to connect to QuickBooks. So we will go ahead and put a check mark next to the one account that we have here, which is our credit card account. Underneath the QuickBooks account column, we want to go ahead and connect our bank account to a QuickBooks account. If you have not set up the account in QuickBooks yet, go ahead and select Add New, and we will go ahead and set up the account here. The first field that we need to complete is Account Type. Typically in this field, you're going to either select Bank or Credit Card Account. So we will go ahead and select Credit Card. The next field, Detail Type, automatically populates based on the information that we selected in the Account Type field. In the account name field, you want to go ahead and put the name of the bank, the type of the account, credit card, and also the last four digits of the account number. If you've got more than one business credit card that you plan to connect to QuickBooks, including the name of the card and the last four digits will allow you to easily tell one credit card account from another when you reconcile these accounts. We'll go ahead and put the same information in the description field. Double check to make sure that you have completed all of the fields before you click save and close. And now you can see we have our credit card here that's linked now to our bank account. Before you click the blue connect button, we need to double check to make sure that you did not select any accounts that you do not want to keep track of in QuickBooks. For example, personal credit card accounts. Once you click connect, all transactions will be downloaded into QuickBooks. Unfortunately, there is no automatic undo button. Later on, if you find out that you accidentally selected an account that you do not want connected to QuickBooks, then you will need to manually delete all of those transactions before you can delete the credit card from QuickBooks. Go ahead and click the Connect button to start the process of downloading the credit card transactions into QuickBooks. Depending on the number of accounts that you've selected and the date range, this could take a while to complete. However, once the transactions have been successfully downloaded into QuickBooks, you will receive a message that lets us know the download was successful. And here is that message here. Fantastic. So now we are ready to actually review the transactions in QuickBooks. So we'll go ahead and click the blue Let's Go button at the bottom. Takes us back to the banking center. And on the For Review tab, all of the transactions that were imported into QuickBooks will be listed here. To learn how to manage banking transactions after they are downloaded, click the links below this video to watch our video tutorial on how do I manage downloaded banking transactions. If you have other credit card accounts that you want to track in QuickBooks, then you can just click the blue Add Account button and go back to the beginning of this video. That wraps up how to automatically download your credit card transactions into QuickBooks. Importing credit card transactions using a CSV file. If you can't directly connect your credit card account to QuickBooks, or you need to download more than 90 days of credit card transactions, it is important that you know how to import your credit card transactions using an Excel CSV file or QBO file. To obtain this type of file, log into your credit card account and go to the section where you can download transactions and credit card statements. Most likely, you will have the option to download your transactions in multiple formats. If you don't see either of these options, CSV or QBO, then contact your credit card company. Let them know that you would like to download your credit card transactions into QuickBooks and you would like to know how to do that from their website. To begin, from the left icon bar, select Transactions and then Banking. On the right-hand side, click the drop-down button to the right of the Update button and select File Upload. On this screen, you want to browse to the CSV file that you have saved on your computer and go ahead and select that file and click Open. Double check to make sure that the correct file is in this search box right here and then click Next. On this screen, we want to go ahead and link our CSV file to the correct QuickBooks account where the credit card transactions will import. So we want to import this into the Bank of America credit card account. If you do not have the account set up in QuickBooks, you can do so by clicking the Add New button at the top and creating the account. Be sure to watch our video tutorial on how to set up your chart of accounts. Click here to watch that video now. Let's click Next. On this screen, we want to go ahead and map each of the QuickBooks Online fields to our CSV data in the spreadsheet. And so what we'll do is we'll go through here and we'll indicate which column QuickBooks can pull this data from. So the date field, we'll go ahead and select column 1. And to the right, we're able to also select the format that we want the date to be in. The description field will be column 2 in our spreadsheet. And then last but not least, the amount field, we'll go ahead and select column 4. When importing amounts, we need to let QuickBooks know the format of our CSV file. So your file will either be one column that will have both positive and negative numbers in that same column, or it will be two columns where positive numbers will be in one column and negative numbers will be in a separate column. Typically, the positive numbers are the withdrawals from your account and the negative numbers are credits or deposits to your account. So we'll go ahead and map our debit and credit columns. The other thing that you want to do is if the first row in your spreadsheet is a header row, you want to make sure that you put a check mark here to indicate that. And once you have made your selections, we can go ahead and click Next. On this screen, we are able to see how the data from the spreadsheet will import into QuickBooks. So you want to verify that the date column has date information in it, the description column has description, and the amount column has amounts in it. So once you are satisfied that this looks good, we can click Next. On the next screen, QuickBooks will verify the number of transactions that it will import. So it'll be our final opportunity before the data input. So we are fine with the 22 transactions, so let's click Yes. Once the data has successfully imported, we will receive this message here. And then we can actually go ahead and click the blue button in the lower right-hand corner that says Let's Go. And we can review those transactions here in the Banking Center. They will appear here on the For Review tab. To learn how to manage credit card transactions, be sure to watch our video tutorial by clicking this link. That wraps up the section on how to import credit card transactions using a CSV file. To access this course or any of the others in the series, just click this link. For a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online, click the links below this video. If you have feedback about this course or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.